Welcome to the Take Flight Show, spring season for Ultimate Hoops down here in Toronto. Right now we got big things going on. We got our Ajax teams set up right now, and we also have our introduction to our Mississauga location as well out here in Toronto. Great teams, great guys, what's going on, and the skill level is gone up another notch.
Yeah, they definitely, from the guys that are coming on board, like everyone could play pretty much now. Like every team is balanced, every team has players that can play, especially in Saga, we saw some crazy talent over there. Guys that actually been playing ball for their whole life, like going overseas, coming back, some guys played CIS a good many years. So there's a lot of talent in both Ajax and Saga, we can see that.
Yeah, for sure. And also too, with this new spring season, we're gonna have a new format where we're actually gonna crown a Toronto champion. So it's gonna be, you know, the top two from Ajax versus the top two in Mississauga to have one Toronto championship. Mm-hmm. So I think that definitely has the guys going and excited about it. The new season. You know, we had to start turning away guys and joining the league because it's got so crazy. Yeah. Right now we got a solid 8 in Ajax and a solid 6 in Mississauga. But I'm looking forward to seeing where this season ends and, you know, who comes out the champion. Mm-hmm.
So going through the first game of Ajax, we had a new draft, really successful. Mm-hmm. Every team seems to be even, like I said before. The first game were the Soldiers versus Jumpmen. What do you think about that game?
Actually, that game was going back and forth. You see the new chemistry and how guys are feeling and trying to figure out who's a guard, who's a shooter, what position, what they get from each other. But the score was going back and forth throughout the time. Close game near the ending, but the Soldiers, you know, definitely able to pull it off. They have a bit more guys that play together.
Yeah, from what Anthony picked his brother, you know, so they play well together right away. And then also with Dehaney and Leon, they play pretty well together. Those guys, they're here last season, so they're already friends, they know who each other are. So they play really well together.
Definitely veterans of the game. The second game of the night was Tough Juice against East Side Goodfellas. Tough Juice looks like a tough team, for sure. They got a well-balanced bench guys as well, and guys that are really much into the game and enthusiastic about the game.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, they have a lot of size. Like, from size, and just because they have size, they're not slow. They still go up and down the court. They have good size. A lot of the guys are, they have IQ, they know the game. So they gave, East Side, they really underperformed, I think that.
Yeah, for sure. You know, they have Pete for three. They have a lot of key pieces, and I think once they're able to figure out, you know, where each person plays and what they bring to the game, it would definitely, you know, make that team a lot better moving forward.
Yeah.
But, you know, overall, two great teams for the night. And in our third game, we had the Durham Flight versus Team Dab.
I would say that, you know, kind of disappointment that the number one pick of the draft didn't show up for Team Dab. Richie Allen, where you at?
Where you at, Richie? Where you at? Team Dab was missing you, you know what I mean? But sometimes that's just how it goes. But you know what I mean, they'll figure it out. Well-balanced team, guards, shooters, big men. Mm-hmm. Team Dab will probably put it together moving forward. But you know, Durham Flight, once again, they got veteran guys in the league from the team. Guys that play together outside of the league, you know, evenings in Lifetime and, you know, doing stuff in the gym. So, you know, that was probably a good win for them early in the season.
Yeah, because that team, I'm pretty sure by week 8 when they play them again, it's going to be a lot different. Because Team Dab, they're all new guys. I think none of them were in the league last season.
Pawan was the only one.
Pawan, okay.
Yeah, definitely. He was the only one. So he's going to probably be the key to bring that team together moving forward. And in our last game of the night, we had the Defas against Redhawks. Big man in the middle, Justin.
Justin, and they're even missing a guy, it's Brown.
Yeah.
He, 6'7", bigger than our current biggest guy in the league right now. So when he's healthy, that team might even be more of a monstrous team.
Yeah, and definitely you can see Justin's on a mission this year. You know, disappointed they weren't able to win the championship in the winter session, but he's coming after it for the spring session. He looked good.
Yeah.
Dropped some big buckets.
29 points.
29 points, you know, inside, outside. He's bringing it. And I think he really definitely wants to put his team on the map.
Yeah, definitely. And then with the Redhawks, you know, they underperformed. I think, you know, it's basic what the Moose did last season with Justin on the defense. He really, you know, he was talking. I think it got to the Redhawks because the Redhawks are talented. They have Dominique Felipe, they have Jerron Kerr, and they have I can think of the names. They have a lot of good talent on the team.
They have, once again, it's all about balance. I think these guys became smart in terms of picking up guards, forwards, shooters, big men. So you're going to see a lot of different teams winning at different points. So, you know, overall, I'm pretty much excited about what's going on in Ajax. All the teams are looking good, coming together, and they're ready to do their thing.
And then moving on to Mississauga. You know, thanks guys for, you know, joining Ultimate Hoops for our first Mississauga 2016 Spring League. The first game, we saw a lot of talent right away from the Gaines.
Yeah.
You know, they had a lot of good players. They have Kareem Tony. He's one of the lifetime workers. Yeah. We have Muhammad.
Big Mo in the middle.
Like shooting from like what 45.
Yeah.
Like so, I think he ended up with 29 points. So. They showed right away that, you know, Mississauga has some talent down there against Team Havoc, which had some decent players too. They could probably need a little help. I think they're missing a good amount of guys, I think.
A couple of guys that were missing, but overall they were still, you know, with playing against the Gaines. They were pretty much in the game throughout. Just near the ending, Gaines started to pull away.
Yeah.
But the one thing I can say I'm excited about Mississauga is, you know, they got ballers. They got guys that want to ball.
Mm-hmm.
You know, they're shouting out. They have their group chats going. You know, they're really taking this full force moving forward with the spring season.
Mm-hmm.
And, you know, shout out to Mississauga. In our second game, it was the Renegades against the Spartans.
Mm-hmm.
These are two good teams, two well-balanced teams once again. The final score was 80-71 for the Spartans. They were able to put away with some big shots once again.
Yeah, because they only had five guys.
Yeah.
They really like they knew when to stop pushing the ball hard, when to slow it down because they only had five guys. So they, you know, took their time most wisely, got some rest. One of the key guys in that team was Naji.
Yeah.
He had 30 points.
Okay.
All down low, pretty much the layups, getting to the basket. You know, he was a glutton for punishment down there. He just wanted to get in there, get contact, get for some round ones. And he couldn't really do without Yusuf, his teammate. He got, what, I think nine assists?
Yeah.
I think like seven was to him alone. So that team, they really meshing together. Then you have Jordan.
Yeah.
So that team's really talented right there.
See, so guys are already making a name for themselves based on the way they're playing.
Mm-hmm.
You know, we see you guys. We see what's going on. And then in the last game of the night was the Force against Alde.
Force, they have one key player, Daniel.
Yeah, Mr. Daniel, get buckets, Daniel. he does it all, man. This kid got game for sure.
Yeah, you're showing elite moves just from the start. You know, step back, spin, dime, everything.
Killing them with the Euro steps. Yeah. You know what I mean? Daniel got game. He was there, and the team noticed that, you know, really put it on his back to carry them through.
Mm-hmm.
They were leading with like almost 1 minute left, up by four, and you know, all day they had the big dude in the middle, Travis. You know, he just became an animal, and ones getting the big rebounds.
Like a Kevin Garnett down there.
Yeah, that's true. Yeah, you know, getting the big rebounds, making things happen. You know, these two teams are looking good. Like, I like what I see with these two teams, definitely.
With Nathan, not to forget Nathan too, he really like pulled that team together and told, hey, we gotta do this, gotta do that. And then at the end, they you know, made it work for them. They made some good decisions and sealed the win for them.
For sure.
53-48 for the all day.
Yeah. So there was some, you know, big scoring that's coming out of Mississauga. Two or three guys with 30 points. You know, they have what is going on right now, so it's going to be interesting moving forward into the spring and seeing where things plays out.
Mm-hmm.
And, you know, see which teams really come through and come on top. I know there's a lot of guys still wanting to get into the league. It's been crazy on Mississauga. We were doing what we can. But for this spring season, we are closing it off at 16. Just based on the competition, it's going to be great, and we want to make sure everything's good. So Ajax, Mississauga, You know, this is The Flight Show, new show, new name, brand new images and interviews and interactions. We're doing all that for this spring season moving forward. We're gonna take it to the next level and continue to grow. You know, we great start to the new season. Happy what I see, and we know we're gonna continue to bring the best service, best game right to you.
Mm-hmm. Guys that are new to the league, well, all in Mississauga and a couple in Ajax, remember that we do have, check out uhlife.com. That's where you guys can see all your stats that you're so crazy about, that you're, you know, asking where they are. Mm-hmm. Articles, videos, pictures, our Facebook group. Connect with one of us to be invited to a Facebook group. It's UH Toronto. That's where I post, you know, notifications of all the photos. When I do post an article, I post on there as well, videos, everything like that. So once you're connected with that, you'll be connected with everything else. So make sure you look through those.
All right, so catch us next week. The Take Flight Show.